हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल। सी प्रीवियसली आपने तुम्हारा इकोनॉमिक्स फॉर बिजनेस डिसीजंस इमेज डिस्कस करता था अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ डिफरेंशिएशन। फाइन, सी बेसिकली मैं तुमने एक बेसिक आइडिया आपेलो अने एट लास्ट जे ई प्राइस डिस्क्रिमिनेशन केवी केवी रीते थाय छे, डिफरेंशिएशन केवी केवी रीते थाय छे ए वस्तु जे छे आपने फोकस करेल बराबर। अहींया जे छे ई अलग अलग टाइप्स आपेला छे तुमने डिफरेंशिएशन। फाइन, लेट अस फोकस ओवर टू दैट पार्ट की केवी रीते जे छे ई डिफरेंशिएशन टेक्स डिस्काउंट फ्रॉम द मार्केट। फाइन, अलग अलग टाइप का तुमने डिस्काउंट आपेला छे, अलग अलग प्राइसिंग वे आपेला छे कि भाई गवर्नमेंट आवे, बिजनेसेस आवे के डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर लोको माटे डिस्काउंट होय के पछी अलग थी जे छे ई डिफरेंशिएटेड प्राइस लेवामां आवे लोको पासे बराबर। तो ई एक वस्तु जे छे एना थ्रू तमने अलग अलग टाइप्स आपेला छे। એમાં ફર્સ્ટ ટાઈપ તમને આપેલો છે અબાઉટ ધી ડિસ્ટ્રીબ્યુટર્સ ડિસ્કાઉન્ટ। ફાઇન, ડિસ્ટ્રીબ્યુટર લોકો જેટલા પણ છે પછી એ તમારી આખે આખી સિસ્ટમની અંદર કોઈ પણ ડિસ્ટ્રીબ્યુટર, ફાઇન ડીલર હોય, હોલસેલર છે, રિટેલર લોકો છે, રિસેલર લોકો છે બરાબર, જેનું કામ બેઝિકલી કમિશન લઈ અને રિસેલિંગ કરવાનું છે। ફાઇન, તો દરેક એ જગ્યાએ જે છે એ જેટલી જેટલી એક ડિસ્ટ્રીબ્યુશન સિસ્ટમની અંદર લોકો એડ થાય છે એ લોકો જે છે એને ડિસ્કાઉન્ટ આપવામાં આવે। ફાઇન, લેટ અસ ફોકસ ઓવર ટુ ઇન્ટ્રોડક્ટરી પાર્ટ, ઇટ ઇઝ ધી પ્રાઇઝ રિડક્શન ધેટ મેથોડોલોજીકલી મેક ધી નેટ પ્રાઇઝ વિથ રિલેશન ટુ ધી બાયર્સ કન્ડિશન ઇન ધી ચેઇન ઓફ ડિસ્ટ્રીબ્યુશન બરાબર। સી, ઘણા બધા વેઝ જે છે એના થ્રુ તમે ડિસ્કાઉન્ટિંગ જે છે એ પ્રીવિયસલી જોયેલું બરાબર, અને પ્રાઇસિંગ પોલિસીની અંદર પણ જોયું। અહીંયા જે છે એ તમને એવું કહે છે કે ડિસ્ટ્રીબ્યુટર્સ ડિસ્કાઉન્ટ જે છે એ એને કહેવાય કે જે જગ્યાએ એકચ્યુઅલી થયું બાયરની કન્ડિશન જે છે બરાબર, કે બાયર કેટલું પરફોર્મ કરે છે તેના પ્રમાણે તમે એને પ્રાઇસ રિડ્યુસ કરીને આપો છો બરાબર। હું 5 સિટી કવર કરું છું તો પ્રાઇસ જે છે એ પ્રમાણે રિડ્યુસ થવી જોઈએ બરાબર। બેઝિકલી જે છે એ હું 10 સિટીને કવર કરી દેતી હોય તો પ્રાઇસ પછી મને એ પ્રમાણે સસ્તા દેવા પડે બરાબર। સો એ એક વે તમને આપેલો છે। સેકન્ડ પાર્ટ તમને કીધો છે ઇટ ઇઝ સો કોલ્ડ બીકોઝ ધીઝ ડિસ્કાઉન્ટ્સ આર પેઇડ ટુ ડિફરન્ટ ડિસ્ટ્રીબ્યુટર્સ ઇન ટ્રેડ સિસ્ટમ, હોલસેલર, ડીલર, રિટેલર, ઇટ ઇઝ ઓલ્સો નોન એઝ ટ્રેડ સિસ્ટમ ડિસ્કાઉન્ટ। વાય સો? વાય ઇટ ઇઝ એક્સપ્લેન્ડ એઝ ટ્રેડ સિસ્ટમ ડિસ્કાઉન્ટ બીકોઝ હિયર વી આર નોટ ફોકસિંગ ઓવર ટુ મેકિંગ એનીથિંગ or manufacturing any kind of product. Fine, here just we are focusing over to the trading system from manufacturer to distributor to dealers, dealers to wholesalers, wholesalers to retailers and resellers. Fine, and in that particular chain we are accumulating the discount. Fine, basically why so? Because each and every party is performing on their own way and they are entitled to get some or the other type of relaxations, fine, in paying the prices. That's why trade system discount is there. And it is not purely target based, but you must have to go for some sufficient or some efficiencies, fine, then and then only you will be able to perform well in the market and you will be able to sell out the product of the manufacturers. Right? So, by that way, they are trying to explain us different discount for different distributors. See, what is the difference between distributor, dealers and wholesalers? Distributors are working at a regional level, at a cluster level, fine, which contains maximum area of your state, fine. And on the second part, dealers are basically the major sellers to ones. Fine, they are actually selling their product to the wholesalers. And if we talk about wholesalers, then they are going to sell to retailers. Fine, so trade system discount enables you to get some of the other type of payment relaxations. Fine. You have been given 3 distributors discount format. Fine, we can do it in a 3 different format. First, we explain as different discount to different distributors. Yes, of course, discount will be given to different distributors on a basis of different performances. And not only performances, but on the basis of how much inventory they are carrying. Fine, because inventory carrying is the important aspect in terms of if we are focusing over to the distributorship or dealership. Fine, on second point they have given that a uniform list price which is decided according to a structure of discounts to different level of distributors. Please make a list of uniformed price. So you must not have to deviate from your profit and you must not have to deviate from your prices even. Fine. Because if you have made the list that if you want to be the dealer or if you want to be the distributor or you want to be the wholesaler, you must have to invest this much. You must have to pay fees to us. You are going to get this much profit from each and every product. Fine, so make a price of a, make a list of a price and then give on it to each and every distributor discount, distributor dealers, basically wholesalers and retailers. Why so and why we need it? Because people, those who are connected with these activities, these distribution system, have must idea about or have must given a thought about that what kind of earning they are getting and how much earning they are getting. Fine. And third, supplementary discount to the level of distributors. If you become distributor and particularly you have been assigned a target and you are achieving it, then they are going to give you some extra discount which is known as supplementary discounts. Fine. And supplementary discounts are really important for the distributors because they are the one who are going to sell your products in the market and distribute it to each and every village or city. Fine. So basically they are the one who are going to target many more customers, and in that particular part it will be needed. So types of differentiation is needed. Let us focus over to the discounts, how discounts determine. Because discount cannot be just a mere short-term decision. You must have to provide it for the longer period of time and only and then and then only distributors, dealers, wholesalers will be connected with you. Fine. So, discounts are determined through following steps. First, they have said that the service is to be done by the distributors. Yes, if the distributors are giving so many services at the same time to retailers, wholesalers or any kind of dealers, then they are the one who can get discount from the manufacturers. Why so? Because you are completing the target of the company, you are targeting the much more mass than the earlier. You are targeting the customer base that are specially connected with the product. Fine. So you are the only one who is going to play an important role in giving services. Second part, they have said that distributors' operational cost. See, you must have to consider distributors' cost. If they are going to promote your product, if they are going to communicate with the people, and if they are going to bear the transportation cost, then you must have to consider about operational cost of distributing. Because if not, then distributor is not alone going to perform well and they are not going to promote your product in the market. Fine. So basically over that part they have given some of the other discounts. Third point, the environment around competition. Yes, it's much needed focus area. You must have to focus. Because discount can be determined through the competition also. The more the intensity of competition, the more the discount will be given to the particular distributor or dealers. Fine. And all that part, you must have to focus over to the competitors' activities relating to other products' promotion. Fine. If you are not going to concentrate over that part, then they are going to make a very, very strong advertisement. And that advertisement will create hurdles in promoting your manufacturer's product. Fine. Fine. So as a distributor, you must have to always focus about the competition around you. Fourth mark, effects of discount on distributor society. How much distributors are motivated, that will be completely based on the discount. And how much discount they are getting, that will be completely based on how much they are selling. Fine. So basically, effect of discount on distributor society is always going to be positive if distributors are performing really well in promoting your products really well in the market. Fine. Fifth, they have been given us that cost of selling and opportunity cost for the market selling. See, what market selling actually we are going to do, or what kind of market we are going to target, how many customers are there and how many of loyal customers are from them, and that must be needed. And in that particular case, you have first selling cost available to you, and the another one is opportunity cost for you, that to which market you are going to target and how much it will need or take your money in advertising expense or service providing expense. Fine. And over that part, you must have to first study the selling cost and then your opportunity cost. If you can adopt the another idea with least cost or with the least investment, then you should go for that idea. Fine. Even if consumers are somehow not familiar with that part, still those who are loyal customers to you and those mass which you are going to target are actually going to buy your product from distributors. Fine. So you must have to focus over to the opportunity cost and selling cost that define your particular discount elements. Fine. So yes, this is all about distributors discount. We have just completed a single part. We are further going to discuss about functional discount, fine, which is based on trade status, and we are going to discuss about its positive effects. Fine. So this is all about today's session. Thank you so much.